Hey guys, what's up? Archer here, and today I'm here to give you the analysis for the September 22nd games on CSGO Lounge. And for the matches, we have Ninjas in Pajamas versus A Gaming, Nodus Vanseer versus Hellraisers, Hellraisers versus LDLC, Planet Key versus Na'Vi, which is Nodus Vanseer, Overgaming versus London Conspiracy, Titan versus Na'Vi, Hellraisers versus Epsilon, Dat versus Na'Vi, and ESC versus Titan. Now, to begin with, we have NIP versus A Gaming. Now, of course, I'm going to choose NIP to win. They're a better team in general than A Gaming, whom have been losing to lower tier teams, like, badly. Either way, if you feel confident, do a very high bet on NIP, or do a pretty low inventory cleaner bet on A Gaming in case an upset happens, which is always possible. Because last I checked, it was like 8% for A Gaming, so that's definitely inventory cleaner bet worthy. Now, the next game is Na'Vi versus Hellraisers. I'm going to choose Na'Vi to win because they have a better lineup than Hellraisers at the moment. Although Hellraisers have been pulling in wins, they've only been winning against MyXMG or Dat, and they hardly won against Planet Key Dynamics. Against teams like Fnatic and Titan, they lose. Na'Vi is doing better, and if Guardian explodes, there's no stopping him. So, next game is HR versus LDLC. LDLC has been doing pretty well, and even showing us that they can take two games away from NIP even, which is, you know, something to, you know, look at. LDLC's only recent loss has been to Epsilon, and that was a 14-16 game. LDLC to win, just due to better skill right now. And honestly, we have to check to see how Hellraisers performs in their first game, so bet accordingly. The next game is Planet Key versus Na'Vi. The last time these two teams saw each other was at ESL 1 Cologne, and Na'Vi won both times. The first game, they won pretty, you know, decision-like costing, like it was 16-10, I think. But they went into double overtime the second game. I'm expecting Na'Vi to pull this one out of the bag, but Planet Key might do something great as well. Bet according to how Na'Vi performs earlier in the day. The next one I have is Overgaming versus London Conspiracy. London Conspiracy has beaten Overgaming both times they've ever met each other, and this is troubling in my prediction because London Conspiracy beat Overgaming on their best map, albeit it was only 13-16 in favor of London Conspiracy. Overgaming may have changed since then though. It was about a month ago that these two went against each other, so the fact that it's tomorrow or today was a month ago, you know, they could put in a shit ton of practice, and you know, we have seen that Overgaming is capable of taking Titans like Virtus Pro down on Mirage. So that being said, let's move on to Titan versus Na'Vi. Both Titan and Na'Vi have been doing pretty well recently, and honestly, I say it's an even 50-50 match. You won't need to bet on this one, unless Na'Vi is doing really shitty today. Just enjoy this bet, just watch it. Like, I wouldn't bet anything on it. HR versus Epsilon, both teams have been iffy, but just because Epsilon have been doing even worse of iffy, Epsilon has been doing pretty shitty lately. They also are going to have a stand-in, apparently, according to HLTV. Someone named, Leporiak Melfik. Fuck if I know. But Hellraisers to win this one, depending on how well they perform earlier today. Next game is Dat versus Na'Vi. Of course it's going to be Na'Vi, depending on how well they perform earlier in the day. And, you know, we have seen Dat cause some upsets, but honestly, we can depend on Na'Vi having the better lineup and the better skill. Next one is ESC versus Titan. ESC isn't a bad team, and we have seen them take out and even go head-to-head, like toe-to-toe before losing against some really high-tier teams. But, you know, ESC has not faced Titan's new lineup, as far as I'm aware. And so it'll be something a lot different, that's for sure. So my choice is going to be on Titan, depending on how they perform earlier in the day. So that being said, at this point, you can just stop listening or whatever, that's the end of the predictions. But the reason why I haven't been making as many predictions as often is because of school, obviously. And because, you know, I do have a social life, believe it or not. Like, I was surprised at how much of a social life I had when I wasn't making videos. It's like, Jesus, fuck. But, I appreciate all of you who do give me the support. I appreciate all of you who have subscribed because of these predictions, and I will be doing more predictions for games that I see fit. So, that being said, thank you guys so much for listening. I am Archer, and I am signing out.